God bless you. God bless you. Listen, tune on in. We here for Bible study. Come on. God bless you. God bless you. We here a little early, but come on in. Tune on in to Bible study. God bless you, Sister Trish. Bless you, Sister Conyers. Come on and tune on in. I want you to share it. Push that share button. Bless you, Brother Adrian. Come on, let's share it. Sister White, God bless you. Come on, anybody know God is amazing? God bless you. Come on, the saints are coming in. The saints, Elder Peter, God bless you. Sing, Lady G. My God, Donald Godbolt. What's up, man? God bless you. We're going to start with a word of prayer. Father God, we thank you for your presence that's already saturating this atmosphere. We pray right now, God, that you have your way. Have your way through every phone, laptop, TV screen, computer, wherever this is being viewed. Lord, we are not here for form or fashion, but we're here to learn more about your word. We want to be better Christians. We want to be better believers. And we pray right now that you have your way. Let the same anointing that's wherever we are saturate that living room, that bedroom, that kitchen, that bathroom, wherever someone is viewing this. Someone's on their way home. Somebody's at home. Somebody's at work. Somebody's in their car. Wherever they are, let the same anointing be where they are. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank God and amen. Amen. Listen, we're here a little earlier because I know that the saints will be celebrating Valentine's Day today. And I didn't want to come across anybody's Valentine. If you know what I'm saying. Welcome to New Grace Tabernacle Bible Study. Amen. And I didn't want to bother with anybody's Valentine. I know people are going out tonight and some folks are staying in, but still going out. If you know what I mean. Amen. So we're going to be on Bible study right now. We're here a little earlier and then we can also replay it later because it will be on YouTube and we can replay it later. God gave me a unique message for you all tonight. And we're thanking God because Mother Missouri is home. Thank God. She was in the hospital for a couple of days, but she is home. So we thank God and we bless the Lord for her healing. We believe God for 100% healing. But God has given me this word for the saints, for the people of God. Listen to Pastor Wright tonight. We must do better about our money. I'm going to say it again. We must do better about our money. And I'm going to talk about it because the saints have no business, I'm going to say it, owing people and running from people that they owe. We got to do better about our money. And listen, if you can't afford something, don't empty your life savings trying to keep up with the Joneses. Don't empty your life savings trying to prove to somebody what you got. It ain't worth it. The saints got to do better pertaining to their money. Amen. And God does not want us to be in debt. I want somebody to just write this in the comments. We're going to decree and declare this tonight. I am debt free. I need you to write that down. I need you to, if you can scribble it down, if you can just scream it out your window. Open your window and yell it out to the crowds, scream and holler, I am debt free. Now, this is what God's plan is for his people. You don't get a financial blessing or a financial miracle for you to stay in debt and go splurging and shopping and go on these shopping sprees and you still got debt. Oh, let me help the people. Oh, I'm going to give you the word of God. I'm going to give you the word of God and what God says. You do not get a financial miracle for you to go splurging and still be in debt. That is backwards. That is not what God desires when he blesses us financially. I'm going to give you Romans chapter 13, verse 8. Romans 13 and 8. And it says this, let no debt remain outstanding except the continuing debt to love one another. For whosoever loves others has fulfilled the law. God does not want us to be in debt. Now listen, we're going to have bills all the day of our lives. As long as you wake up in the morning, you're going to have bills. But bills and debt are two different things. All right? God does not want us to be in debt. And when you are getting financial blessings and financial miracles, it ain't for you to splurge, to go get the newest car, to go get the newest clothes, but you still in debt. Because if you do that, there'll be a continual cycle of you being in debt. And you'll continually need God to give you a financial miracle every other week. You continually need God to give you a financial miracle every once a month. And we should not need a financial miracle every month. A financial blessing, hallelujah. But a financial miracle, God got to move the heavens and earth because you can't handle your finances. He's blessed you with it already, but you got a hole in your pocket. He's blessed you with it already, but you didn't do what he told you to do with it. Amen. And it's yes, we tithe, but it's more than just tithing. It's also tithe and offering. And it's more than just tithe and offering. It's also pay your debt. And tithe really is a debt that we owe, that God willingly has us willingly to do. Oh, somebody say amen. And I'm going to show you in the word of God where God wants to bless you financially. He wants to blow your mind, but he wants you to pay your debt first. Let's go to 2 Kings chapter 4. I need you to share this with a bunch of folks that you know need help with finances. I need you to share this. We're going to break the back of the enemy tonight. We're going to break the back of the devil because we want to say that the devil is attacking our finances. Sometimes it be us. It be us. And you know, don't y'all act funny with me on here tonight. Some of us got shopping demons that we need God to deal with. Oh, you know folks got shopping demons. And you need God to deal with that shopping demon. Let's go to 2 Kings chapter 4, verse 1 through 7. And it's a very familiar passage of scripture. I'm going to read the New Living Translation. One day, the widow of a member of the group of prophets came to Elisha and cried out, "My husband who served you is dead. And you know how he feared the Lord. But now a creditor has come threatening to take my two sons as slaves." So this is a woman, the widow woman, they would call her. She had a husband. Her husband was a good man, served the Lord, but he dies. And in that time, when the husband died, the two sons were now responsible for the mother. So now the husband died with a debt. And now the debt is passed on to the wife. And now the creditor has come. He's not coming. He's there now. The creditor is there right now and going to take her sons as slaves. Watch this. "What can I do to help you?" Elijah asks. "Tell me, what do you have in the house?" She says, "Nothing at all except a flask, a bottle of oil," she replied. And Elisha said, "Borrow as many empty jars as you can from your friends and your neighbors." You'll stick with me. Verse 4, "Then go into your house with your sons and shut the door behind you. Pour olive oil from your flask into the jar, setting each one aside when it is filled." So she did as she was told. Her sons kept bringing jars to her, and she filled one after another. Watch this. Soon, every container was full to the brim. "Bring me another jar," she said to her sons. And the son said, "There aren't any more," he told her. And the oil stopped flowing. When she told the man of God what had happened, he said to her, "Sell the oil and pay your debt And you and your sons can live off of what is left over. She needed a financial. Anybody ever been at a point where you needed a financial miracle? God told her, Lord, I love you. Sell the oil that I just blessed you with. You didn't have enough. The man of God spoke. God spoke to the man of God and he stretched it. Sell the oil. Don't give it away. Sell the oil. Watch this. Pay your debt first. Then you and your sons live off the rest. God is telling you, I'm going to bless you. I'm going to give you the financial miracle that you need. But it ain't for you to live your best life until you pay your debt. Pay your debt, then do what you want. Good God Almighty. And that's where we have a problem, because we don't want to pay what we owe. We got bill collectors still calling us, but we going out on vacation like it ain't nothing. God says, pay your debt. I know I ain't going to get no help. I ain't going to get no help tonight. Pay your debt first. Everybody that you owe, pay them and then live off the rest. You don't get a financial blessing or financial miracle and then you just do what you want to do and still leave your debt unresolved. You got to, and you got to be able to control yourself, because sometimes we get financial miracles and we can't control ourselves. We get financial blessings and we lose our doggone mind. First place we go is to the mall. Oh, I know I'm talking right. First place we go is down to Family Dollar, like we done hit the lotto. We go from Family Dollar, then we go to Dollar Tree, and then we go to Dollar General, and like we done hit the lotto. First thing we do, hit the mall, go to King's Plaza, go to Green Acres. But God said, pay your debt, then do all of that. And when you do it like God says, you won't need a financial miracle every week. God will set you up for life. And what she got, that oil that she sold and what was left over, was enough for her and her sons to live for the rest of their lives. But she paid her debt first. Anybody tired of the bill collectors continuing to call you, and then God bless you, and you forget that you owe Sally? What's the people that got the what them call them, the school people, the tuition? Sally Mae been calling some of us every month, and we ignoring the call. People calling us that we owe credit card companies, we ignore the call. Got a new car, they calling you, talking about they're going to repossess. You take the plates off and hide the car. You done got financially blessed. I know a time coming up. I know the tax season coming up, and folks about to get this blessing and about to get your... And let me tell you this, just so you know. Tax returns ain't a financial miracle. That's what's due to you that's supposed to come back. Now, when your tax return come and you got debt, but you ignore your debt and you go buy a new Honda Accord, you got a problem. Because now you got a new Honda Accord, which adds more debt, and you haven't dealt with the debt that you already got. Good God Almighty. Now you got all these new clothes, but you don't want to deal with the debt that you left behind. Pay your debt first. You got folks around you. Some of y'all got family members that you still owe money to. Okay. Yeah. Some of us got people in the church that we shouting around, still owe money to, get our money, get a financial blessing, and then we act like we don't know nothing about what they talking about. When you owe somebody and somebody lent you money, it is not their job to remind you that you owe them. Oh, I'm preaching better than y'all saying amen. That's all right. It is not somebody's job to remind you that you owe them. You know you owe them. Well, I thought I paid you, but you know, don't you do that. Oh, I thought I paid you back. When? You know you ain't paid nobody back. You thought you paid me back. You're lying. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. So, just like this widow woman, she got the financial blessing, and she did exactly what God says. And it was easy for her to do what God said because she already did not have enough. She was planning just to go ahead and let them take her sons, and sooner or later she was going to be dead and gone because she didn't have no ways, no means of finances, no means of gain. She had nothing to live off of. So when God takes your nothing and makes something and tells you to do something with the something that he made out of nothing, you ought not have a problem with it. I said, when God takes your nothing and makes something out of nothing, and then he tells you to do something with the something that he made out of nothing, you ought to have no problem with it. And I'm a living witness that I've seen God take my nothing and make something out of nothing. So when I didn't have enough to begin with, I was on my way down anyway. So when God finally does bless me, I might as well do what he says to do with it and trust him, because I didn't have enough to begin with. Oh, help me somebody. You didn't have enough to begin with. Had it not been for God touching your finances, giving you a financial miracle, giving you a financial blessing, you wouldn't have had the little bit that he told you to pay your bills with. So pay your debt first, then live off the rest. And it's nothing, vacations are wonderful. But vacations, knowing that all your bills are paid, or even better. Because you can take a vacation and you all got all this debt and got all these bills, and you out there trying to enjoy yourself, got your feet in the sand, but your mind is going. That's why some people take vacation, and when they get back, they need a vacation from vacation. Because you never really rested. You never really got to enjoy it because your mind was constantly on what you got to handle when you get back. But vacations are even better when you got your feet in that water and you know your bills are paid. Ay-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi. Vacations are even better when you out there with a pina colada virgin, a virgin pina colada. Amen. And you know, when you go home, your car's still going to be there. It ain't repossessed because you paid the car note. Vacations are even better when you got your feet in the sand, your toes going all like this. Nice, got the nice pedicure, toes going all like this in the sand. And you know your bills are taken care of. Vacation is frustrating when you on vacation and your phone keep ringing because the bill collector's still calling you. You're frustrated because you don't know if you get home if your lights are going to be on. You don't know if you get home if your car has been repossessed. That's not vacation. You just went away. But vacation, you're able to lay aside every weight. And God wants that for us. Hallelujah. God wants that for us. Stop buying stuff that you don't need. I'm sorry. I got to teach like this, y'all. This is what God gave me tonight. Stop buying stuff that you don't need. Some of us got clothes in our closet, still got tags on it. That's proof right there that you purchased something that you did not need, that was not necessary. But then you find yourself in debt. And wonder why. Where did my money go? Where did this go? Where did that go? Look in your closet at the stuff that still got tags on it. That means you ain't even worn it yet. And then you look in the closet, oh, I got to find somewhere to wear this. That means you didn't need it. You got to find somewhere to wear it? Listen to us. I'm sorry, because I don't want to get in nobody's personal business. But, oh, I got to find. We buy stuff with the hopes of finding somewhere to wear it. Living beyond our means. Hallelujah. Well, the word of God is right anyway. Amen. Let me give you Proverbs chapter 3:9, and I'm going to leave you alone because we got to, I know you got to do the Valentine's Day stuff. We got to do it. Amen. Hallelujah. Jesus is our Valentine. Amen. Proverbs chapter 3:9. Watch this. Honor the Lord with your wealth and with the first fruits of all your produce. With the first fruits of all your produce. Honor the Lord with your wealth. So if you want to have wealth, God is expecting you to honor him with your wealth. Don't you dare forget about God when you get wealthy. And somebody should have got happy right there, because I didn't say if you get wealthy. I said when you get wealthy, don't you dare forget to honor God. God does not bless us with financial blessings and financial wealth for us to forget about him, for us to forget about his principle. He wants us to be good stewards. He wants us to be good stewards. A good steward doesn't mean you're cheap. A good steward means you understand what God wants you to do with your finances. Amen, somebody. A good steward, and when you're a good steward, he said, that's why the Bible says he gives seed to the sower. If you are a sower, some of us are givers by spirit. We just give, give, give. I know a pastor down here comes to our shop all the time. I'm not going to call his name because then some folks want to borrow from him. But he's just a giver, a giver, a giver. And you just have no idea how blessed people are. And I got to look into his life a little bit. And this man is almost, he's a doggone millionaire, because he's always giving. And those who are always giving will never be broke. He'll give seed to the sower. He'll give you, the sower will always have harvest. And some of us will give people the shirt off our back if we could. Some of us will give, we'll make sure everybody else got before we got. Because that's just the spirit that we have. We're givers. And God is going to bless the givers. He's going to give seed to the sower. Amen. And I want you to know this. When you have debt, you got to pay your debt. God is not a messy God. He's a God of order. We serve a God of order. We don't serve a God that wants you to run from bill collectors. And I'm going to be talking about this because we don't want to say it, but finances causes a lot of stress on us. Many of us are financially strained and it's stressful. Trust me, I know, but I've learned to turn it over to God. I learned to do things God's way. I've learned to pay my debt. Because if you're debt-free, you already rich. Come on, I want somebody to say it again. I am debt-free. Say it in your home. I am debt-free. I am debt-free. I am debt-free. And I want to pray. This is an economic, financial prayer. Thank you, Lord. This is an economic financial prayer tonight. Father God, I pray right now that you touch our financial situations. God, I pray that you touch our mind when it comes to our finances. Lord, you said you give us the righteous desires of our heart if our ways please you. God, help us not to live beyond our means. God, if there's an overflow, give us an overflow. God, if there's an overflow for us, don't let us strain for the overflow, but grant us the overflow. Help us to pay our debt, God. Make us debt free in the name of Jesus. Matter of fact, God, I know that you're able, before we even get off of this live tonight, to cancel debt. You're able to cancel debt. And if you do it this time, we're wise enough tonight not to put our foot back in the mess. We're wise enough tonight not to jump in the same messy pool. But we're wise enough to do what you said. Pay our debt and live off the rest. In Jesus' name, thank God and amen. God bless you tonight. Listen, we want you to sow a seed. Those of you that are going to sow a $50 seed, God bless you. Sow into this word. I want you to sow into this word. Our Cash App is $ New Grace Tab. Our Zelle is PastorDave14@gmail.com. And our secondary Zelle is jwright.gracetabernacle@gmail.com. Our PayPal is PastorDave14@gmail.com. I want you to sow that $50 seed, that $25 seed, that $20 seed, $10 seed, $5 seed, however the Lord is leading you to sow on this word. I want you to do it. God bless you. Listen, we will be in service on Sunday. We're expecting God to move in a mighty way. We had an awesome time on this past Sunday. God moved in a mighty way in our Family and Friends Day. We took in, I believe, 8 new members. Thank God. 8 is the number of new beginnings. And we took in 8 new members. This Bible study, if you know a member that has missed this Bible study, it will be available on YouTube and you can forward it to them. I'm going to forward it to everyone tonight. So those that were not able to get on, they can get on later on whenever they can. God bless you. I want you to enjoy your Valentine's Day. I hope you got your Valentine, sweetheart. I got my Valentine. I don't know about you, but I got my Valentine. I got a lifelong Valentine. She already knows it. Will you be my Valentine? No, it's automatic. All right. Love is in the air. Amen. Love is in the air. So God bless you. You make sure you enjoy yourself tonight. Go eat. Go enjoy life. And know that God is with you. Pay your debt. Amen. God bless you. Peace. And we'll see you on Sunday morning. There will be prayer Friday night on the prayer line. And we'll see you in church on Sunday morning. This is for all the lovebirds out there.
Did you look at me differently, love?
Happy Valentine's Day.
Ever since the first moment I spoke your name, from then on I knew that by you being in my life, things were destined to change. Cause love,
we singing this Sunday, y'all.
People use your name vain. Love,
God bless you.